Hi nerds, hi yogis, Carlene Rose here, and welcome to a Nerdy Yogi YouTube channel and a Nerdy Yogi studio. Today we are doing a Yoga Shred inspired flow for Black Canary. The DC Bombshells Black Canary is very cool because she is a singer, so you always see her with the microphone. It's like one of those old school microphones singing. So we will be working on building a strong core. Obviously a strong core is great for vocals and singing, so we'll be inspired by that today. To start to warm up though, we'll come in ankle to knee pose because we'll also be hitting our glutes while building our core. It's going to be kind of a total body singing experience for us. So start with right leg on top. You're going to inhale here and tiny arch, stretching out the abdominal wall. Exhale. Perfect. One more time here. Inhale up. Little baby arch, opening the front of your body. Exhale. Now this time we'll come to a twist. So inhale up. Exhale. Hands come to heart center. Twisting towards the right. Turning to warm up our side abdominal wall as well. Awesome. Back to center. Inhale. Again, arch a little. Exhale. And now we'll switch legs that are on top. So just a gentle warm up for the legs. Inhale up. Get that big morning stretch. You know when you're getting out of bed, you're stretched. Doing that here in our seated position. Exhale. Inhale up. Exhale. Very nice. This time as we exhale, we'll twist to the left. Remembering, of course, as we're breathing to inhale, expanding the low belly, and exhale, squeezing everything in and out of the nose. Last time here, inhale up. And exhale. Very nice. All right, so now we've got a gentle warm-up. We'll come into our, we'll start with down dog and then go into our plank challenge. But we'll start grounding our fingertips in the earth, coming onto our palms, very light in the heel of the hand. Start with bent limbs and then walk your way back to a downward dog position. Pedal out the feet, warming up the backs of the legs. And from here, we're gonna bend everything, get close to the earth, wave yourself forward into plank, come onto your knees for good shoulder health as you lower through chaturanga. Inhale here, prepare and exhale. Wave yourself in and up. And back to child's pose. You can rock back and forth. Awesome. Now our bombshell blasts are a pretty quick workout, so we get a quick warm up, do our yoga HIIT exercise, and then a quick cool down. So pretty simple, right? So today for our HIIT style pose, we're going to be in plank. So you want to make sure you've got that same grounding, really pressing to the earth with the fingertips, and coming into a plank here. Now, if your wrists, you don't have to be right over your wrists. If your bone structure isn't built that way, you can see mine's just a little off. It's not totally perpendicular. So you don't necessarily have to worry about, especially if we'll be a plank for a long time, having your shoulders directly over wrists. You can back off a little bit, get some good alignment in the wrists. You want healthy joints. And from here, you can also do this on your knees. I'll probably mix it up, you know, challenge yourself, but we are going to lift one leg, bring it to the outside of the same arm, lift it, and corkscrew. And of course, on the other side, lift, we'll alternate sides, lift, and twist, and back. And we'll just keep doing that until our Tabata timer tells us that we're done. So we'll get that started here. And of course, we can take a break and stretch during our 10-second rest between rounds, but we'll come into plank. And again, you can do this hands and knees. Sometimes I like to start on hands and knees to warm up. So coming to the outside and then corkscrewing it. And do remember to lift up when you lift the leg. Get a little bit of that booty. We're gonna kick our asana here. So you can stretch, interlace the fingers behind you. Come back into your pose. Remembering to breathe. And go at your own pace. You want to find something that's challenging, but still fun and not so terribly difficult that you maybe give up. But if you need, you can always sit out around, rest a little more. Awesome. Ground into the earth with your fingertips. Come into your aligned plank. And find a good breath pattern that works for you as well. Obviously, in yoga, we tend to, or at least the vinyasa style yoga we do, it's a lot of moving with the breath. Breath guides the movement a lot of the times, whereas we're doing more of the HIIT stuff, you kind of just have to breathe sometimes when you need to. Shake out your wrists, massage your forearms. Magic wrist clear before going back into it. More rounds left. Feel free to hit pause if you need like a water break or anything, but make sure you jump right back into it. And if you need to breathe out of your mouth instead of your nose, do that as well. Awesome. This last round, let's mix it up a little. Let's bring our knees straight forward. So just lifting up, bringing it to the center. Again, you can do this from hands and knees as well. Make sure. Oh, psych, we have one more round. So we'll do that again. Massage out your wrists. And again, you can do it from hands and knees as you're building strength. Or on plank, you can even come to center, or come to the side. Come to the side, come to center, corkscrew it. So a lot of fun things you can do, but we're done. So feel free to take any variety next time that you do this practice. Mix it up, why not? And from here, just inhale, open the arms wide, stretch out the belly, exhale. And inhale with the arms up, knee back bend again. And open the arms wide, exhale. Open the arms up to the top for back bend. Exhale. Very nice. We'll stretch out the arms for just a second. We use those, of course, while we were doing all of that work. So stretch one arm across and switch sides. And release your fingers behind you. Get a little bit of an arch here so you're stretching out the abdominal wall that you just worked so much. Awesome. Shake out the wrists again. Do that magic wrist clear. Then we're going to come back into plank for just a moment. But this time, bring your right knee to right wrist and slide back into pigeon. And you can rock back and forth to find a comfortable position, making sure that your leg is going out straight behind you, not winging off to the side. And front leg, you do want it rotated. It's with, you can see here with the natural alignment of the knee. Flexing your foot's gonna force it to twerk, which we don't wanna twerk our joints. So keep a, more of a pointed foot almost to find that comfortable position and not be twisting your knee joint. And inhale, open up, getting into our hip flexor. And then exhale, wave yourself forward. Inhale, tiny wave, and exhale, folding down into a comfortable position. Think of waving the spine long with every inhale. Exhale can then take the stretch a little deeper. Really letting gravity do the work with this one. And to get into our side abdominals that we worked as well, we're gonna moonwalk. So coming over to the left side, again, find a comfortable way to support yourself and reach the right arm longer. Getting into the right side body. Awesome. Walk yourself back up. Press yourself back into plank. This time, left knee comes forward to left wrist. Walk your right foot back, rocking back and forth until you find that comfortable, healthily aligned position for pigeon. Inhale here, wave the spine in and up tall. You can lift off of your legs a bit, lift them off the ground even to deepen the stretch in the hip flexor. And then exhale, forward fold. Inhale, waves the spine longer as you slowly wave yourself down. Finding that comfortable first edge of stretch. And then we'll moonwalk the other direction. I'm gonna hit my wall, so I'll scoot up for a little bit. So moonwalking to the left arm reaches out longer, getting into the side, left side body. It's great because you are doing your pigeon stretch while doing the half moons. You're stretching so many things right now. Awesome, walk yourself back up to plank. This time bending everything, pushing yourself back up to down dog. Wave the spine long, let the head and neck and shoulders relax. Heels are just naturally going towards the floor. Then make your way to a child's pose for a moment. And if your heart rate has settled enough from your hip style pose, just lay yourself down onto the mat. You can hug your knees into your chest, circle them one way, then the other. And extend out long onto the mat, coming to your final resting pose. Hopefully you enjoyed that practice. I had a lot of fun with these. I think the bombshell blasts are a blast. Be sure to hit the subscribe button if you're not already subscribed to the YouTube channel. Leave up the notifications for when the next bombshell blast is up for you. As well as I've got my League of Nerdy Yogis email list. Got exclusive content on there for you. So make sure you're on that if you're not already. Namaste.